Hey everybody, it is Tisa and I am back finally to creating and making videos after a long hiatus from my move. So I'm here with, for the love of crafting and sharing, and we are creating layouts with kits today, kits or collections. And I am using the Stay at Home collection from Pink Fresh Studio. As you can see, I'm going to be creating with some stitched hexagons. And I cut these out using my hexagon dies from Close to My Heart. I absolutely love these dies because the large hexagon is like 4 inches and it's just a perfect size. I love, love, love them. If you're interested in those hexagons, please leave me a message or you can message me on Facebook. I am a Close to My Heart consultant and I can get you connected with getting some of these for yourself. So back to the layout. So as you know, this is kind of a quarantine type collection. And I am scrapbooking a picture of one of my best friends, Jen, and I. And we are scrapping together through FaceTime during this quarantine time. We often scrapbook together, but we also try to get together every other month. And we have not been able to do that for so long. I miss her so much, and I'm just grateful for the technology that we do have where we can see all of our crafty friends. So I'm arranging all of these hexagons and kind of going back and forth trying to just make sure that the colors are all balanced. I didn't want anything too heavy at the top. And that's kind of why I didn't like that yellow colored hexagon shape up at the top. And it with my eye, it felt like it worked out a lot better going down towards the bottom right corner. So that's kind of what my thought process was with that. I also did not want the white background papers. So the one with the hearts and the one with all of the icons. I didn't want those touching as well because I just felt like it would be too busy and not enough separation with those light backgrounds. So this is the arrangement that I came up with. And I cut out a few other hexagons in smaller sizes. And you're gonna see where I'm going to kind of put those about making somewhat of a diagonal design. With kind of a little bit of a triangle mixed in with that. You'll see how I lay those out on the layout as well. I am going to cut down my layout and cut down my paper and back this with a blue pattern paper. I do gut that pattern paper as well because I love that color blue. And I just didn't want to waste it. I know that seems silly because I have so much paper and honestly, I probably wouldn't miss it, but that's okay. I am going to do it anyway. Sorry I left all this cutting in. I usually do not leave this in on my layouts, but I am a little bit rusty. I moved on August 7th. And so it has taken me a bit of time to get my scrapbook room put together to where I could start creating. And then honestly, I got my room together and I just had a mental creative block. And it has just taken this much time for me to kind of get back into the groove of things. And I've missed it so, so much, but I'm so glad I'm back. And yeah, I'm hoping to create a bunch again this weekend and get some more videos up for y'all on a more consistent basis. All right, so here we go. I think, yeah, at this time I did not have my ATG gun out, but that's okay. I am backing the photos with scraps, as you can see. And I'm using just little pieces of scraps and I'm just kind of backing them all So there's a bunch of different layers. And then you'll find I'm going to back the whole thing with some cardstock that will just tie it all together. And I really love how that photo turned out being backed with all those little bits of the colors that are in the layout. You can see a close-up, a better close-up photo of that at the end. But what I did like is how the cardstock, which is actually from my stash, it's a close to my heart cardstock in thistle, and the color really went well with this collection. But by backing it all in a bunch of little scraps, but then taking one solid piece and kind of mounting it all onto that solid piece, I felt it really grounded that photo, but yet gave some interest with all the other different patterns. I hope that makes sense. I haven't done a voiceover in so long. I might not be making any sense at all. And I also have to apologize that I'm obviously on a whole new setup and I keep moving my page down where you can't see the bottom, and I have to get into a better habit of pushing my layout to the top. So bear with me for my next few layouts because I'm really going to struggle with this for a bit, and I'm going to have to put some tape down or something that is going to be a reminder. See, here I've got my layout now anchored on that blue paper, and I love how that looks. That's where I'm going to put my photo, and I am going to pop it up with some foam. I'm just going to use the fun foam for that. And now I'm going to start placing my additional hexagons. So the blue hexagon there, I put up on fun foam, and then the yellow, I kind of layered a little bit underneath. And I'm going to do the same thing at the bottom of the layout with two additional hexagons. Now I pulled out all of the, well, I pulled out some of the ephemera, the die cut pieces that I thought I might use. And you're gonna see me just moving things around like a crazy person. I mean, I didn't know where I was going with this. I have so much ephemera and stickers. I mean, there's just so much that came with this collection. And I wanted to be careful not to like over embellish this one, because if I over embellished, I felt it would take away from all of those hexagons. So I wanted to keep it kind of simple. And I do end up with really four clusters. And I'm okay with that. It kind of seems like a weird number of clusters, but I really do love how it turned out. So I'm going to keep those hearts up there. And then I am going to pop up the flowers right by the photo. And then just a small cluster down by the hexagons at the bottom, and then a little bit more over by my journaling spot. So when I'm embellishing, I mean, you can see exactly what I'm doing, what I'm putting where, but I want to just go over how I embellish. I typically start with either my ephemera pieces or stickers first. So I start with anything flat and large. That's the first thing I look for. Then when I've found something that I think is going to kind of be the base of each of my embellishment clusters, depending on how many I choose to put on there, then I go to my next thing, which is usually something a little bit smaller in size, and usually something with some dimensions. So either chipboard or puffy stickers, something of that nature. So in this case, I didn't really add too much anything in the medium size to the upper cluster, but the one by the photo, I did add the puffy camera sticker. And then at the bottom where the journaling is, I have those houses, and then I added that chipboard circle piece. So after I've gotten that medium piece down, then I'm going to go for something smaller, or even go right into that sprinkling effect, which is my last element. So I did not add anything smaller in any of the clusters except for by my photo. And I added some strips there that say video chat, scrapbooking, and then a few little hearts. And then my final step would be adding those little puffy stickers, enamel dots, Nuvo drops, anything like that. That's more of the sprinkling is what I'm looking for with those small pieces. So I hope that helps you regarding making your embellishment clusters and how I kind of think through them. Typically, I do that for each layout. It doesn't always work out the way I have planned in my head. So, of course, you always have to be ready to kind of switch things up if you don't like the way it looks. But that is kind of a good rule of mine, that I start from the largest, flattest pieces, and then I go to the very smallest pieces at the end. And I try to make sure that I have all of those different items in each cluster. Now, I don't have puffy stickers in every cluster here, but that's okay. It's still balanced, and that's what I'm looking for. I don't want one cluster to have, you know, even one or two. Even if one has a whole bunch of stuff, but the rest of the clusters are balanced, you know, are similar in size, I'm fine with that. Like my middle cluster by my photo, that has quite a bit more than my other little clusters that surround it. And that's okay, because that big cluster is going right, drawing your eye right to the photo, which is what the goal is in every scrapbook layout. Now the other ones, they're just little ones. They just have little things here and there, and that is perfectly fine. But I wouldn't want two very large clusters, because if I had that, where would my eye go first? It wouldn't know where to go. So only having one really large cluster by the photo, my eye is automatically drawn to that photo. So that is what helps me in determining where to put certain items on my layout. The whole point is get your eyes to move to your photo. And using that kind of rule of thumb really does help. So you've watched as I have added all of my little clusters, and now I'm putting a title, and I used these silver small letters, which I think were from Chamel Field Trip. I actually found those at Tuesday Morning quite some time ago. And then I just added social distance scrapping. And I was trying to come up with a better, like more unique, fun title, but I just couldn't, and so I just kind of went with what made sense to me. I am not the best at coming up with creative titles. If you want to watch someone that has creative titles, you should follow Rachel Reynolds. She does the cool, just like puns and fun, cute little titles. Like her title really does tell the story, and that's kind of what I strive for. But I don't always succeed because I just can't always think of everything. So finishing up those letters, and those multicolored letters are from the same collection. So of course the colors go perfectly. Now, other than the silver thickers or the silver letters, everything I've used is pretty much from this collection. I did use a couple little puffy stickers that might have been from somewhere else. I can't remember. But pretty much this whole thing is from this collection. And I'm really loving how it turns out. So there are a bunch of ladies, bunch of YouTubers who are in this monthly hop that we do. And I hope you will check out all of their channels below. They are so creative, and I just love that everyone kind of comes up with something very different, and it's really fun to see what everyone comes up with. Now, this month, like I said earlier, we were instructed to use a kit or a collection. which is what I did here. So definitely check the links below. If you're not a subscriber of mine, I would absolutely love it if you subscribed and hit that like button. When you hit the like button, it does tell YouTube that you like what you're seeing and it will show my video more. So here's some close-up pictures for you. I hope you enjoyed this process and I hope you all have a great day. Bye, guys.